All right, gonna try a new camera angle here.
Yeah.
And I got myself in the seat. All right, so. So I wanna confirm where I left off. So I'm still gold here. Still good. Looks like I'm well below the threshold, which is great. On this one, I still got a little bit of movement there, which is just decent, so we're good. And now this pain in my thing. I'm like 2 seconds almost below the silver threshold. However, gold is 115.956. That actually went up. Or no, it went down. Oh my god, it was like 116 point something, 0.11. And now it's 115.956. So, I mean, 2 million secured. This puts me at like the 4,000s, 5,000s. Can I, you know, get down to maybe the 2,000 or 3,000s? I don't know. When we're talking about, you know, shaving a couple of seconds off, it's tough. Like, we look at all these numbers and they're all like really, like low 16s. They're already getting close to the 2,000s. So they're not even a second faster than me, and they're still pretty well up high there. Which kind of sucks for all of us. But I mean, if we're talking about like crazy amount of people, like millions doing this, then it's not too bad. As we can see, like there's a lot of people within those 16s. But you know what? I'll just keep going and try to work on that. See what I can do. I'm gonna need gloves for this. These are not racing gloves. These are actually quite cheap, but they have like this texture, this zigzagging texture that helps really grip the wheel well, which I like. And the good thing about these gloves is these cost like $10 Canadian, maybe 11 with tax, at Decathlon, I don't know how to say it, but you know where it is. So I bought that there. Not expensive. Kipsta, the brand, they're cheap and they're good for this. I didn't feel like spending $70, $80, $90 on racing gloves just because that's a little ridiculous. For shoes, I'm rocking my Pumas. I always have. I don't really tie them. I just slip them on. It's better than slippers. Here we are. Deep forest. And I don't use any assists, like default. However, with this vehicle, I have turned the traction control up a little bit. And then my other problem, so I think when I did the 116, I went with a -2 towards the front. Not quite sure why I did that, but it seemed to work for me. I don't know if it's good or not. I could probably try, because my thing is to try to come to a stop as fast as possible or slow down. And usually these vehicles, the rear for some reason is better, but I think I found that on this one, the front actually helped, having the bias to the front. I don't know, I might be wrong. And then traction control, I was rocking a 2. Reason being is, so 0, getting out of these tight curves, I almost always spin because I'm giving it too much throttle. But then on traction 1, same thing was happening slightly. So obviously I need to work on my throttle control. But traction 2 is where I was happy. And you know what? Let's go. And I know, like, it's a hard time to beat already. Mine. not sure if it has to do with my driving line not being the greatest or what it has to do with, but see what I can do. I'm not even going to put the seventh gear on this. Like I'm already going quite slow. This is definitely slower than my fastest lap, because at that point I think I was at 39, and here I was in the low 49 seconds, so yeah. I don't know about this. Trying to stay close to that, but 18, so not great. Why is not working? I don't know. My mind might be wrong. Maybe I tried this and I think I might be wrong. Maybe I tried the front bias and somehow in my head I think that's what I was using. Might not be, actually. Might be wrong. Let's test this out. I'm having a hard time braking there. Seems like I was braking a lot better the other day. It's been like 2 days since I've done this. That was it. Still not fast enough, but I can see the improvement. So I was totally wrong. I thought I had that when I did that fastest lap that I had done, that I had the bias towards the front, and I didn't. Now I should be closer to my... Okay. Too slow. I might have found a little secret there. I might have to get out of that turn on second gear, because I made up a lot of time that I lost in the beginning. Ooh, now I slipped. Okay, that's not normal with TC2. I don't like pedal to the metal with this car most of the time. I'm not sure if the heavy hitters are using any traction control? Probably not. Still do better than my previous lap. Maybe not, because I'm already up to speed. My hands are cramping. Close. To something. Not quite 800ths of a, or 0.8, but I'm onto something. I can probably get below. If I could do better throttle control, I'm sure I could save a little bit of time. Sure. So now we're below 17 again. It's like all the time I made, I lost. Damn. This is tough. Yeah, second gear there also does not work. Really gotta go down to first. Why is my hand cramping is the question. But I'm not inconsistent right now, which is good, but not a good lap at all. Getting worse again. Terrible lap. Terrible. quite sure why my hands are cramping so much, but they are. This point and I'm actually able to save time. It's the first little sector there that I suck at. And I put on brakes a little too late, I think. To what I was doing, but not at the point that I want to be at. This is a tough one because you have to be in the top 1.5%, which is really tight. Also pays you double, right? So. It's like I lose a bunch of time on that first sector and then I make it up here. And then I lost it again. I'll drop to one, even though that's not going to make it any better because my throttle control is not... Holy, maybe my force feedback is also a little too much. Yeah, definitely not worth it. Okay, let me figure this out. So TC2 is obviously my best option. Let's try the big brake balance 4. Like, I was close. I need to find a better way. I need to also find a better way to do that over there. That little area there, that turn. I messed up there too. messed up here, and I crashed. Oh my god, it's so much money thrown in the garbage. Okay, let's try this again. I'm just gonna restart instead of like wasting time on a lap. I have done laps with no traction control, but I lose a lot of time getting out of the curves because I'm trying to straighten the wheel so it doesn't spin. So I just find with TC2 that I'm able to, you know, put down more power. Now, I don't know. I don't know if it makes a difference or not. Son of a... See, most times, on most times when you're doing these hot laps on GT, as long as you touch the apex, they don't consider you out of the track. But on this one, I find that as soon as you put one wheel out, it just does not count the lap. It just fails you right away. My god, I think I need to turn down this 4-speed back, man. It's a little ridiculous right now. I might be wrong. Really tough. This is one of the toughest, or the toughest challenge so far. I'm usually able to get gold, but not now, man. Not now. And I lost time there too. Up there. I applied brakes too late. Not much slower, but nope. Now, am I braking too late? Is that why? Could also be that. Trying to brake too late and then I end up losing speed throughout the corner. I'm suspecting that might be an issue too. Try to break earlier here. Let's see. Seems to slightly work. then I'm losing time. It'll put me like close to my previous record, which is good. I'm still like with one of the tires is still on the apex, and I find that on other races and other challenges it doesn't really matter, but on this one it matters for some reason. It definitely matters here, which makes sense, but there's green there, so I might not know the rules properly. That might be the problem. But if there's green, I don't know why it's counting me outside of the track. But if it does it for me, it does it for others, so can't really complain. son of a bitch. It's such a tough, so tough. And here, this curve, I'm not quite sure what I can do better, to be honest. Gotten close to my previous, but I'm definitely not getting gold, because I don't know where else I can shave time. So definitely the 5. Maybe I can stop earlier. Still didn't even go positive. Now I'm gearing too late. Alright, let's try 0. And a spin. See, I'm not even turning and it's still... I mean, it's my fault for, like, putting too much throttle in. Maybe TC1, but it doesn't really matter because regardless, I'm gonna feel tempted to throttle, and it's gonna throw me off. It's gonna throw me straight into the side. So, Whatever, let's try with one. Just for the shits and giggles. Okay, yeah, it's really tough to get out of the corners with TC. Really, really tough with TC1, even TC0. Because I'm tempted to throw the power down and I just can't. I know I should probably do it gradually, the throttle, but this car just, I don't know, man. I kind of feel like I have to give it full power there. That was TC1, so I don't know what else to do. That's about enough. So I mean, there was improvement, so can't really complain too much. A bit of improvement, a little bit. Oh, let me guess what kind of muffler I'm getting. Instead of giving me bars of gold, it keeps giving me mufflers, so this should have dropped me a little bit. Okay, now in the 4000s. I was in the 5s or 6s earlier, not quite sure, but look how fast this guy is. That is so fast, this Italian dude. Actually, all these guys are really fast. That guy's like in first. V Gallo, man, like that's... I'm under, like I'm not more than 2 seconds. I'm actually below 2 seconds slower, but 2 seconds in this is like a massive amount of time. I'm in the 2.44%, and I know I keep trying, like I've come a long way since this thing got posted. I started like 18 or something, 118, 19 maybe, and then I dropped to 17-ish, and then eventually I got below. This guy from my town, I'm just below him, not by much, but he's really fast too. Every time like he's usually above me on every single time attack thing. He's always above, so he's quite fast. Not sure if he uses a wheel or what he's doing, but he's actually pretty fast. Now I want to see this Vigallo lap. Let's see this guy's lap. See what he's doing. Obviously, he's probably not using traction control because these guys that are that fast are just so good. So, whoopsie daisy, clicked the wrong button. Let's go back here. I just want to see what I'm clicking all over the place. Just want to kind of see. I'm going to put the camera that I use, because this game obviously doesn't have just the dash camera that I prefer. And let's see, so he's going in 6th. So up to here we're fine. He stops at the 100. Second, drop down to first and then back to second right away. So here he's already about a second faster. See here, so goes here, 17, 18, stops, okay. Goes in third. he's at like 29 there, and he's at 27. And here he does about the same thing. So, I think I'm usually at like 40 here, 40 or 41 by the time I exit. So he already made up his 2 seconds, or second and a bit. He already made it up before getting to this point, which means I'm probably fine up to here. I'm probably doing not too bad here. I'm guessing where I'm losing time might be way back, so gotta analyze this first turn again. Wish there was a way to slow down the footage. So he slows down here, drops down to second, goes down to first, gives it a third. So I usually drop down to first way before, which slows down the car maybe too much. He does a fourth there, which I did, goes third, yeah, same thing I did. But he puts his third a bit earlier there, goes down to second and then first, but puts it straight to... So let's remember this here. Hey, my God, this 10 seconds felt really big. So I want to see... So it goes here. I want to see where I'm at this little green patch here. Okay, 28 seconds is what he's at there. And then I think the rest, I'm not concerned. I think it's up to that point. It's up to that point where I'm... up to that point where I need to make up the time, except it's extremely difficult. I don't think I can view... Can I view mine? Pretty sure I can't. Nope. What I could do is put the ghost. I just don't like putting the ghost. Are there any new races, actually? There are! I never go on these because there's no... Oh, spa again. Good. What kind of cars can we use on this? GT3 vehicles. What times are we looking at? 215. Ooh, that's... My God. My fastest was like 219 something on a Assetto Corsa on GT. I'm not even sure what my GT3 class is. But yeah, 215 is kind of what we're looking at for this. What car? I didn't even pay attention. So the Supra, got the Genesis, Supras again. Supra just likes the fishtail. I don't see the Renault, which is a car that I like using lately a lot. There it is. There's a guy in 27th with the Renault. I might just go with the Renault. I like how it handles. And I usually just need to put like TC1. Let's get back to, let's go test out this again. My arm hurts. Ah, man. Okay, so I think it's, this one's almost guaranteed that nobody's gonna, like I should be fine. Half of a second faster than what the gold requests. So that's 2 million right there. And then this one I should be fine as well. Like 600s, 6.6. Still has 8 days, who knows. But when I look at the list here, a lot of the names up on the top are a lot of the same names I usually see. And then this one's just ridiculously difficult. But we'll give it another try and see what I can do. I am using the traction control too, which probably is not helping. That guy also didn't look like he had traction control. At least it's not showing that on the screen. Unless it deactivates the button, but I doubt it. I'm sure it shows everything that you're using, so whatever. Okay. 116.660. I need 115 something. Probably not happening. Let's see. Let's go with TC2. I'm gonna use my bias all the way to the rear. I feel like that's when I was stopping the fastest. I don't know if I should turn down the force feedback as well, because it is getting pretty strong. And I haven't worked out in like 3 or 4 weeks because I'm on a special diet now. Nobody can tell, but... Already a second slower. So definitely there, it's that one area. I know exactly where I'm losing my time. I'll stop like midway here. Careful here, because this, it likes to say I'm outside of the track there. I don't think my laps are slow by any means, like, definitely fast enough, but... Terrible. Yeah, I don't know. That guy's gearing. I just can't do it. My driving line is just so messed up right now. Yeah, I don't think I can, I can't mimic what others do, it's tough. I have my own way of driving, obviously everyone else kind of does. And I didn't put the second gear, but I didn't really care too much there because, that fourth gear is so tricky. Maxes out so quick. So I'm going to enter slow, I think. Yeah, definitely. And a fishtail there for some reason. Not good. I'll give it one more lap and give up. I mean, I'm in the bottom 3% or top 3%, so I guess that's something to be happy about. This thing is fishtailing now. Yeah, I give up on this. It doesn't work. I can't do that gearing. It's just... it's tough, so let's go on to Spa. Spa from Belgium. 2.44%, I guess that's a win for me. And it's still worth 2 million credits, so if all goes well, I should be way below, let's see this, I should be way below a couple of seconds from getting to... yeah, like, at least 2 million guaranteed. Like, I would have to... a lot of people would have to make up for 2 seconds. There. So, I should be fine. It would have been great, because I could have got 8 million. But I'll get 6, most likely. Which is fine. On this one, I don't even remember where I ended up. But I'm, like, top 2 or 3,000 or something. Fives. Okay, I thought it was less. Maybe it's the other one. Actually, like, I don't even know. I thought it was. This one, I'm not even that fast. And somehow I have gold. Whatever. But let's do some qualifications here. With my good old buddy. Where is he? There he is. The Renault RS, which I like. And racing hard, racing medium. I do have racing medium. And I will put on the nice shoes, okay? And then I'm looking at 215, I believe, which I'm not gonna get close to, but, okay, got the mediums. And I'm not gonna race, I'm gonna go ahead and try to qualify, which might take some time, because I wanna get close. Usually my target is to get between 3 seconds from the record time. So if the time is 1 minute, I would try to be below 1 minute and 3 seconds at best. Obviously on these, I cannot choose the brake bias, and this car I like using Traction Control 1. Although, it has this area, which I don't know the name of it. Man, it feels so slow compared to that thing I was just driving now. So wide too. Maybe I gotta get in. I feel like this car is actually gonna do really well here. This feels really, really slow coming from the GR10. Like really, really slow. I feel like I'm driving my RAV4. I forgot this has 7 gears too. Such a moron. This car on this track, so I gotta get used to it too. Driven it on other tracks. Why didn't I not get like some penalty time there? The game just knows like my lap time was so butchered that they're like, penalty for what? Why do you need a penalty? Should I enter here in third? No. Okay, I need to figure out the gearing better. They really got the force feedback. God, this son of a mother. I am pooping the bed right now. But they definitely got the force feedback a lot better now than it was when the game first came out. Look how much slower than the fastest lap. That's 9 seconds. That is absolutely ridiculous. I wonder if this car is just really slow too for this track. It can't be, because there was a guy 27th position that used this car, so I don't think it's the car. I think it's the driver. Okay, let's shove a 7th in there. Why are you not making up time? You're losing. Maybe the 7th is not the answer. So screwed. Oh man, so bad. Second gear good enough here? Maybe it is. Not sure if I need to go in first. Could almost not use traction control, to be honest. Oh, great. Now you decide to just spin? This is gonna take some time. So second gear here might be okay, might not, I don't know. Fastest time at on a set of course of competition, which is more realistic, better than GT7. If only GT7 had the physics. But it's okay, because GT7 is really good for what it is. It's a good entry level thing. I think I may have gone too far out over there. And I definitely butchered that last couple of turns. I butchered it really bad. I lost a lot of time for sure. Definitely butchered it. Still within. Come on, you're not gonna get out of the track. Ah, I'm being slower than the last lap. There. Really shouldn't. Okay. Okay, that's seconds. Okay. Remember, it's 3 seconds that I'm looking for. Again, below 3 seconds. I didn't need to go that far out. Totally messed up there. Totally messed up and lost a lot of time. Should I try to go in fourth gear up ahead there? These next two turns.
Thank you.
that far, but. I did want to try fifth gear here, just to see, but it doesn't work. Terrible decision. Now I'm not even focused, because I already know this lap is slow, so I'm not too concerned anymore. ACC with this. This is me with basically a GT3 car, or whatever we want to call it, GR3. On just a few laps, less than 20 for sure. I haven't done 20 since I started to try this here. But right away, low 218s. That's where the difference is with these two titles is the two titles have such a big difference in fidelity. I'm sorry for the pauses, but has such a difference of just the fidelity, the force feedback, just the physics. That you can make a huge difference on your times and such with such low effort, I find. Okay, maybe I should break instead of keep going. With such low effort compared to ACC. ACC took me, man, this almost snapped my finger up. Force feedback so strong, and it's only on like. Seven. It's 100% on the wheel itself, but on GT I have it at like 7, level 7. Maybe I shouldn't drive with one hand. It's not made to drive with one hand. But the reality of it is that ACC is just so much bigger of a learning curve. Like, we're talking about a huge learning curve, and this son of a... I'm just gonna restart. Actually, whatever. Such a large learning curve on ACC. I'm down like 0.2 already. Compared to this game. But we gotta also see what one title is and what the other is. This one's obviously more... accessible to everyone. While ACC is more hardcore. Definitely hardcore, in my opinion. Which one's more fun? Probably this one. Not in terms of driving, but in terms of just what it offers. This game offers just so much more. And what I mean by that is not in terms of like the quality, but in terms of just content. This game offers a lot more content. That curve terribly again. Going back to this. Yeah, a lot more content on this game, a lot more vehicles, different, like the quality obviously isn't the same. I think ACC offers way more quality for what you get, like small package and high quality, being made in Italy, just like they make their shoes, low production, high cost, so same thing. I feel like I'm getting slower now. I kind of already beat my objective, so I'm just kind of, I don't even know what I'm doing here. I could go with LTC, but I don't know. I feel like with these cars, I don't really care if I'm using a tap, a little bit of traction control. Like I can go ahead and test it out, but it's not going to make a huge difference. I'm probably just going to spin out. I'd rather not have to do so much throttle control because I'm not super great at that. Slower than I was earlier. A lot worse. I think I'm satisfied with what I have here. And okay, top 2000. I'll take it. That's actually pretty good. I'm satisfied. So let's get out of here. And my driving class is C now. I was on B, but yeah. It's so much cleaner to play on C, and then B, I just had a few races, got to like quarter of the bar, I would say. Where do we see that? Yeah, up there. I got to like a quarter of the bar on B, and then just started like doing really bad, you know, getting booted out of the track, and then also getting into collisions myself. Just, I don't know, man, I feel like B is a very tough driving class to be in, and it's very tough to maintain. Like, they'll boot you out of the track and you get a 5-second penalty, and I'm not the only person who goes through this. My driving rating is S, so I am very careful. Sometimes I'll, you know, smash into a guy by accident. Usually that happens when I brake a little late. It might happen. I might be driving too close to my opponent, and then because of that I get too close, he or she brakes a little early, and then I can't even get in right now. Oh no. What is this one all about? Oh, interesting. I know for a fact I'm not gonna do well here. With these fast cars, I don't know. 119. Let's test it out. Let's give her. Let's see what kind of time I can get on this one. You guys know what I mean. A lot of you probably go through the same issue. Just, you go up a class, and then all of a sudden, I don't even know if I should be using TC on this. I haven't driven this car at all. I just bought it the other day when it came out. I didn't test it at all. I don't know if it's faster or slower than the previous one. But I guess we'll see right now. Brakes a lot faster than I expected. A lot faster. I could probably do that flat. It turns like crazy too. Yeah, I probably shouldn't use zero TC on this one. Whatever, just trying to get used to it. Let's go. Man, this thing brakes so fast. I mean, this shouldn't be a surprise to me. Oh my god, it is really... actually really tough to the braking zones that I'm doing are terrible because I'm braking as if I had a GT3 car instead of a Formula. Let's try one more with OTC and then go from there. So I can brake a lot earlier down on that first turn, I know that much. And at 39 is like 20 seconds slower than the fastest lap. Now I don't know if I could flat do this flat. Ooh, I turned too early. Yeah, I knew that. But I know for a fact that I can definitely do that turn flat. I just gotta turn better. bastard. My goodness. Okay, yeah, forget it. Because they put the slowdown zone. The slowdown area, they put it right on the streets. Like, why don't you put it on the other side? So that a guy can get punished, but at least start the next lap fresh. In this case, I would start, like, a few seconds behind. Or a little bit behind. This is not fair. I thought this thing would be faster. It's not even hitting 300. So I'm gonna go to the... Okay, let's go. So I gotta try to cut through here. Alright, attaboy. Eee, it turns like crazy. Definitely need to brake a lot later here. That's another issue. And even then, it's still stopping so quick. Slower, but at least a little bit closer to what the fastest guy has. Fuck me. I hate that turn. What I can do, I'm gonna have to repeat this because the slowdown area is like way far. I should also try to bring the car closer here. Let's try again. So the slowdown area should not be on that straight. It's just stupid. I feel like I can. My braking zones is what's holding me back. And just my throttle control being absolute poopsie. It's very doable to not use TC with this car. ABS, I have it as default, so it just uses whatever cars use, I guess. Okay, here's the moment of truth again. I'm gonna turn. Attaboy. Sudden feel so slow. Should probably try to avoid apexes, eh? It's probably a good idea. Okay, I'm gonna brake at the beginning of that yellow. Second faster. maybe not even. This is a very tough, these cars are just so fast. Please don't give me a penalty. Seconds. TC1 there. I'm never really good with formula cars. I'm not. Now TC might not actually be good for this. But might also have the opposite effect. Above half a second, which is a great success, but still not quite where I want to be. Okay, more than half a second shaved. That's all right, but still not what I want. Okay, dropping it to second is probably the best option there. Out of the track. Not really. But it did quite well. Lap again, but I mean, I'm still so up high in my opinion that it doesn't really make a big difference. Okay, so the secret is right there, nailing this turn. Come on. Okay, gaining time, losing time, I don't know what the hell's going on. What time is it? 250. No, shaved a little bit more off. Getting closer to that 3 second buffer. That was terrible. Slap does not count. Yeah, it definitely does not count. So now I think I am braking a bit too late there. Get back into it. Maybe if I used third gear earlier, I would have been below the 123 on the previous lap. Maybe. I don't know. Definitely apply brakes too late here. So. Son of a little Tinkerbell. I just kind of wish it started on the straights and not down there. It's like, what am I doing, warming up tires? I don't know why games do this, but just start me like right here. If the car's already rolling, what's the point of starting all the way back there? Wasting my time. This thing doesn't hit 300, eh? Maybe it does on a longer straight. Gotta do better now. That's a penalty. Yep. Might as well start again because the penalty zone is on the straight. Tremendous nonsense. Nonsense. I really thought this thing would be faster. I gave it a nice paint job though, except the front. There's something missing there. I still need to work on that front. It's too bland. Way too bland. Time there for sure. I do for sure. I'm losing a ton of time there. Okay, here I need to do better, obviously. You have to slip. Come on. faster than previous lap, but slower than my actual lap. Still beat my previous time, but not get under 123. My God, so shaky on the streets. Okay, so like new record, but not satisfied. Fucking 10 seconds later. Yeah, no drunk driving. So I need to come wider and turn faster here. But I got excited on the last lap. Again with this crap, man. Ugh. Keep turning way too early. I gotta put it in my head that I can only turn when I get to that 50 mark flag there. That's the only time where I can turn it. It's just such a tough turn. It really is. At full speed. Like, it's not that tough if you're not going at full speed. Actually, it's always tough. Even with the GT3 cars, now that I think about it. Okay, let's try this again. Faster or slower? We'll see. If I can get below that 123, I'll be happy enough. No, I couldn't. Great. Guess I gotta keep going again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oopsie daisy. Man, it is so tough. Now that I came up with. Sure, I'm out. Okay. Thought I was getting a penalty. Thank you. this doesn't do really anything. Anyway. Still below my my actual time. So much speed on that fourth gear. I don't understand. It loses way too much speed on the fourth gear. Lose that, but I just can't get to it. Keep messing up in certain points. Not sure what happened there, but it cost me 200. beat it, but I'm so close. One, two, three, four. Why? What do I do? No, I'm gonna go fifth gear. Not the 3 seconds, but I just don't feel like it's going to, I don't know, I feel like it's enough for today. Let's see. Because I think it was 119,500, so I'm still, so 2021, 22, I'm still like another half a second. Oh no, look at that. I am within 3 seconds. All right, that works for me. So position 2,871. That works. I think my car is prettier. Simple but pretty. And we can confirm that just by looking at it. Race picture. On foot. Let's take a look. Maybe make a thumbnail. But maybe not here. Maybe it would be cooler around the curve. Alright, let's try to get a thumbnail here. Maybe down here. it's going to look really cool. It's right there. If I do this turn correctly. Alright, let's see. Ooh, touched the grass a little bit. That's okay, because a little bit of grass is good for your immune system and also your kidneys. Wonder if those things are 3D rendered. They are, dude, the bumps. Wonder if the tires actually flex. I never paid attention to that. And it's hard to tell if they... I don't think they do. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. I don't think so. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they don't. But whatever. Let's raise this. Maybe give her from this side. Coca-Cola. Let's give her like this. Oh, yes. I do need to do something about that front. I think it's way too simple. And this game obviously renders things looking so cool after you take a regular picture, so... Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Okay. So, save. Take the screen Reno shot. And I guess that's it. I've done some productive work today on this. Yeah, so productive. That is it. Have a good one.